so forth. And sometimes, you guys know what? We actually very, you know, we always look at how we look. Are we pretty? Am I pretty? Am I beautiful?
Right?
So I dress like...
I thought my eyelash was coming off.
That's what I was gonna say. Is my eyelash is going off? And that's what you just got in the beginning of the show. But anyways, here at Let's Talk World, here at Chancla's Cantina by Thunderbird, 1215 South Las Vegas Boulevard, you guys can get a really good drink here. And also good food. It starts at 5 p.m.
Yeah.
And we're gonna have those on the next show, actually. And you know, it's so fun to just be knowing people, talking to people, and just learning what they do. Business people. Yeah. I just actually finished Manny C having the Power X drink. And we have musician, Duke, Mississippi Juke. Last week we have this nutritionist who just actually literally educate us how we gotta eat the right way.
So much, yeah. I still go to McDonald's, sorry Jill. But I listened.
And you know, that's really funny because this show is free to everyone. You guys wanna come down here, share your passion, share your story, share what you guys do, and we will get it out there. And you know what? Imagine you come and sharing your story like a normal people, organically.
Yeah.
And you were having some drink.
Yeah.
Wasn't that a life?
I mean, it sounds like a nice afternoon.
Exactly, right? I had a very bad day today. But you know what? This is the thing. When I said bad day, it doesn't mean that affect me emotionally. Mm-hmm. Or, you know, it's just like, I will say bad day, but then I'm like, I'm still having a good day.
Yeah.
It could have went better, but you know.
Yeah, exactly. I love that. But anyways, guys, I have Michael and Lisa right here. And what's your show all about?
Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. We are doing a brand new show with social media shows. It's going to be so great. It's called Culture Pop Las Vegas with Lisa and Mike. We are going to be doing a different year from the last 50 years every week to talk about the music, the history, the culture, the fashion, the movies. Because we feel, and I think I can speak for both of us, that growing up like we did in the United States in the 70s and the 80s, influenced who we are as people. The different things that we experienced, the different music that shaped us, the movies that we watched.
What are your backgrounds in music? Let's start with mine.
Me, I don't have that much background in music except listening to it a lot, you know. But
that's your background, is listening to a lot.
Yeah. He also works.
You know, that's my background too. So don't feel bad because that's my background too.
Yeah, that's true.
Go ahead.
So I listened to a whole lot of it, so I know a little bit, you know, and I wasn't too just turned off like to every form, you know. I listened to all of it, you know, not that much country or, you know, probably more. I could have listened to more.
So you love pop music?
I like pop, I like rap, I like metal. I listen to everything really.
Oh, metal!
Yeah, he likes heavy metal like a lot.
Yeah.
Tear it up, Maria!
I don't know if that's what it quite sounds like.
That's metal, right? Like,
yeah, that's it. You got it. You got it. And the hair, right?
Oh, the hair too, right? The head banging.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. I remember that.
Yeah. Oh, you got it.
Yes. That's why I grew these.
We're gonna put.
That's why I grow my hair too.
We're gonna put you on the hood of a car for a heavy metal video.
But that's really, really cool.
Yeah, that'd be amazing. That's so the show, we're just going to look, like I said, at a different year.
Mm-hmm.
Like, even some of the TV commercials that we watched as kids.
Oh, yeah.
Like, I still remember those jingles.
Wow.
Like, yeah, it's like just like a fun way to give a little bit of history, a little bit of background, what was happening in the headlines in that particular year. I'm really looking forward to it. We're having a lot of fun with the research.
Yep.
And then one of the segments of culture pop that we're really excited about is Med Talk, and that's Mike's segment. And every week he's gonna review three different strains of marijuana from a local dispensary.
Oh my God, a lot of people love that.
Yeah, so
they will be like, whoa.
Yeah, here in Las Vegas, there's a dispensary on every corner. It's like Starbucks, right? So there's so many to choose from, so many different varieties.
You say Starbucks,
yeah,
I love you.
It's like Starbucks here. They're everywhere.
I love her now because you say Starbucks instead of McDonald's.
Maria loves Starbucks.
Yeah, go and get me some.
But there's so much to know and to learn about all the different, and it can be very beneficial medicinally, but not a lot of people know how or what quantities or what strains. So do you want to speak to that at all?
Well, I would have, but you said most
sorry.
Of it.
I know, I do that. I get so excited.
Yeah, so I'm basically going to visit a different dispensary every week and give you my review on it, try some of their wares. And sometimes I'll ask them to send in somebody for an interview, so sometimes I may have a guest, sometimes I may not. But that's okay, I can still review them no matter what.
Yeah.
So no matter what, you're always going to get something from me every week.
Yeah, and Mike has been a weed smoker for what, 30 years?
Yeah, so I kind of might be a small authority on subject, you know?
That's okay. I haven't. You see, I'm a rule breaker, but I never step out from trying, you know, trying exciting things like pot in my life.
Well.
But because you know what, there is a reason why. Because if I'm gonna start, I'm already crazy, guys. How much more if I start actually smoking pot? Do you know how gonna be crazy? Oh my God.
You might get some sleep if you smoke the right kind.
There's some really good kinds out there. Some of them even give you more energy. So I could only see you rolling
more wound
up. That's
dangerous.
You'd be like the Tasmanian devil rolling through here.
You see, you're the first one that actually agreed with me. Everybody was like, no, if you're going to do it, you're going to be like, I said, no, I don't think so. I don't like to actually being very, what do you call it, like, they see my boobs or see my kind of a little bit of my butt kind of thing. What?
Revealing.
I'm not that kind of person, although I'm very revealing with my shoes.
We do love the shoes. We do love them.
Yeah, thank you. But anyways, maybe I'm not very revealing, but if I start using pot, I might be too revealing.
You just
out
go
there.
Up and down the strip flashing.
Yeah.
Well, see, this is why I'm making the show. So that way, like someone who hasn't smoked, you know, you can see the research I've already done for you, so you can know what kinds will affect you a certain way.
Oh.
And that way, you know.
Oh, so there is something that.
Yeah, you can even
oh,
do like little.
Oh, it's just like a medicine,
you can
huh?
Do like
it
little,
is, yeah.
It
but
is
it's a natural medicine.
It is a medicine.
Oh,
know?
That's why they actually put a medicine in.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
Why it's
oh, okay, got you. Now,
so
now,
I have a
now I'm making an understanding.
I have a prescription for anxiety for marijuana, but we've seen it help cancer patients. We've seen it help all kinds of
people with insomnia.
Insomnia,
people
eating
that
disorders.
Can't eat.
Yeah.
It helps with a lot of different
PTSD,
ailments.
Like sleeping. A lot of different. Yeah.
Yep. It helps out a lot.
So Mike is really excited to share that information with people.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
So, anyways, I grew up that marijuana is a drug, and we all grew up that way.
Yeah.
Yes, it's just recently that has been actually legalized. So, but literally, okay. So, I have young kids when this was legalized.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, and I start judging my kids using this.
Yeah,
and it's already legal.
I mean,
I was like, don't you freaking use that. You're gonna freaking do this and do that. And then everybody was around me just using it and they were literally doing it. And hey, do you want some? I'm like,
yeah.
And then I remember one day I walk into my house and I can smell pot. And I literally like ran off to my daughter. Like, will you fucking that? You freaking dumb! Anyways, and every time I smell that, it's just like give me a headache. Honestly,
oh yeah,
it gives me a headache.
It is pretty pungent.
Some people get paranoid when they smoke too. You know,
some people do. Yeah, they don't love it.
Yeah.
Yeah. So anyways,
it doesn't agree with a lot. Everybody.
Yeah. Exactly. Give me a headache, and then I remember I think my daughter wasn't actually smoking inside my house.
Oh.
You know what she said? And I heard her with her friend said, my mom is smoking. I don't know what my mom is smoking.
So maybe it was just a neighbor or something? But you know, when we were kids,
my daughter said that, and I'm the one who is actually on drugs.
You guys were like, you did it.
My daughter said, we never smoke inside the house. I don't know what she's smelling, kind of thing. That's what she meant. She's like, my mom is on drugs because she's smelling something.
Yeah, they're like, we just ate corn dogs. What are you talking about?
Yeah. That's hilarious. No, I was mad at the time, but looking back, I'm just laughing because now it's legal. It's legalized. Yeah. It's legal. Everybody around me are already doing it.
Doctors, lawyers.
Yeah, lawyers, everybody. Yeah. And it's just extra, like me.
Grandmothers. Not you're a grandmother.
I just cannot. I don't know, but yeah.
Yeah. Well, we were kids, they used to lump it in with other drugs that were actually very dangerous.
Yes.
And we're starting to recognize that it's, you know, it's not the same.
Yeah. Oh, did you guys watch the Lost with Leonardo DiCaprio? The movie.
Oh,
okay, this is a movie. They actually went, they were stuck in an island and they're smoking pot. You guys supposed to watch
that
it.
That sounds great. Yes. I mean, yes. If you're going to be stuck on
this
an island.
This is like 2000. Around 2000.
Have you seen it?
Yeah, I think it's 2000. It's 1998, I think.
We'll have to take
a look.
Yeah, the
long. I saw Revenge of the Nerds 2. They got stuck on an island and they found a bush.
What is that?
Revenge of the Nerds 2 was a movie in the 80s and they got stuck on an island and found a bush.
Oh, this is 1990s movie.
Gotcha.
You should watch it with Leonardo DiCaprio. It's so. I literally like. Maybe if you are smoking pot, you would understand the hand. But I don't, so I didn't understand the hand. I'm like, they keep me hanging, honey. That's not a good movie. But everybody loves it. Like, every single one that watches it loves it. Give a good review, except me. I'm like,
you weren't stoned, Maria.
What is the hand again? That doesn't fucking make sense. But anyway, all right, so the Culture Pop is all about, you know, they all about.
Yeah, all about different, like different music, different fashion, different things, whatever was happened to be going on in that year, like the top 40s radio, the top movies, what people were wearing, what their hair looked like, which,
ooh!
I mean, that was like the 80s were a crazy time.
Oh,
so
yeah.
We're going to do.
Are you guys going to be wearing the clothes for
probably at some point, yeah.
Yeah, you should be actually like, oh my God, you better see the teaser.
Yeah.
It's coming out pretty soon.
I'm so excited. But I was thinking like I would wear my 1990s prom hairdo, which was very cute.
Picture that you sent me one day.
Yeah.
I love that. I'm like, wow! That is kind of like, who's that girl with the white dress and she's putting it down? Marilyn Monroe.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's a good one.
Yeah, did you see that hair is the same thing as yours?
Yeah. Yep.
Classic.
So vintage hair and makeup is like my passion, one of my passions. I probably will do some of that stuff as well.
Oh my God, this woman actually is a jack of all trade. And behind that jack of all trade woman is a great man.
Yeah, he's cool.
It's the way around now.
Yeah, he's so cool. Well, we're partners, you know, so he helps me, I help him.
That's amazing. And you are amazing, Mike, just to let you know. You are great, the way you actually interact with people, only a few people will see you, and I see you.
Darn, I was hiding so well.
he is hiding, like really, literally I'm hiding, and I'm like, you know what you think? I'm the kind of person that see people, and I said, no, honey, you're naked to me.
Yeah. But he does that same thing that you do. When something happens, he goes, oh, I saw that coming. And I'm like, what?
Yeah.
How did you? Yeah.
I remember you said something when I called you, and you said, oh, yeah. And I was like, that's the reason why I know you now. Because listen to this. The people who talk too much and talk less, you see, I know what they're revealing and what they're not revealing.
Yeah.
I know. Goodness, I felt like I'm a psychic or thing, but I'm not, okay? But anyway, so your show will be every
Tuesday. We're so excited. Every Tuesday at 3 p.m. And there's a really good lineup on social media shows on Tuesday, so watch the other shows as well, because it's really, really great.
By the way, Lisa is my personal assistant.
It's awesome.
She just got promoted.
I'm learning so much.
And you guys just promoted us.
Operations manager.
She is now the operations manager.
I will be managing the operations. Look out.
Yes. Everybody goes to her before me. Right? Yep.
And you only get to get to her if you get through me.
Yeah. That's why I love this woman. Thank you so much, guys.
Oh my gosh, my pleasure. My pleasure. Oh my thank God. You.
I love you both. Thank you. And thank you so much for, behind my back all the time.
Yeah.
Or what do you call that? What do they call it? I got your back.
I got your back. I got your back, and I'm happy to.
And I got you got my back.
Yeah.
Is that how you say it?
Yes, we got your back.
Okay. You got my back. I got you got mine.
And I couldn't ask for a better teacher.
Oh, no, I'm not a teacher. I'm just actually a learner. I'm a student like you too.
Yeah, but she sat on Google Docs with me for 25 minutes this morning going, click here, click there.
I'm trying to, I'm patient, but I only choose people who to be patient with. How's that?
Yeah, I mean, I guess I showed you that I was trying.
No, you are good. Oh, no.
Like, I can't find it.
No, she is freaking wonderful.
Oh, thank you.
It's been a big help having you. Actually.
Thank you so much. And we are going to achieve awesome things. I can see it already. It's already happening. We have amazing things that are happening every single day at social media shows. I'm just getting bigger and better every minute.
Especially with Culture Pop, come on.
Yeah, so look out, world. Here we come.
Here we come. Thank you so much, Lisa. Thank you so much, Mike. You're amazing. Amazing couple. I love this couple.
And I'm excited about your next guest.
They're my number one couple. Number one couple. I love them. You see the love and, the affection and the partnership.
But
I don't know what's behind the door.
Oh, yeah, hi to Mike's mom. She's recovering from surgery. Hi,
oh,
Karen.
Oh, hi, Mom.
Hi, Karen.
Oh, I'll get better to her, right? Remember? And the parking lot, I talked to her.
Yeah.
Hi, Mom. This is me, the one talking to you.
get well soon.
We love you. Thank you so much, viewers. We have one last guest. And you know what? We saved the best for last.
She's awesome.
So up next is Carrie Brown. The queen of entertainment, or the ambassador of entertainment here in Las Vegas,
Royalty.
Nevada. Royalty. So we will be right back. Don't go away. Don't miss this out. Thank you for watching Let's Talk World. I hope you enjoyed our featured guests for the day. Please visit us on socialmediashows.com, subscribe on our channel on YouTube, and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and Periscope. Don't forget to share and like and comment on our show. Thank you so much, and I'll see you guys again next week.